Hello everyone, in this video I am going to talk about Proc Freq. Proc Freq is one of the most frequently used Sas procedure, and the main purpose of using Proc Freq is to check the distribution of categorical variables. So categorical variables are basically two types. One is nominals, when categories are not in any order, for example gender, city, and ordinal categorical variables are like when categories are ordered in a meaningful way. For example, here like status, high, medium, and low. And Proc Freq, as I told you, is mainly to determine the frequency of the values found within each variables. And I will give you an example here. This is a data set, example one. So you can see there are three variables here, x, y, and z, and I wanted to know that what is the frequency of different values of a variable x, for example. So I have to write this program, Proc Freq. You have to provide the name of the data set, and table statements you have to write, and you have to describe the name of the variables here. So table statement tells Sas to return, n wave frequency in a cross-tabulation tables. So you can see that how the results is going to come. I am running this two program all together, so you will get an idea that how the frequency procedures give result. So this is the original data set. You can see I check the frequency of x variables. So x, so in x the number two values is 3, so frequency is 3, and percentage of this value is 42%. You can see, you can manually count here, like 2 is coming 3 times in this data set. So this is how the frequency is calculated for each values for the variable x. And if you have any missing value, you will see the missing value is also reported, that frequency missing is equal to 1 here. So this is how the Freq is going to work. And this is for the another data set, just to easy understanding. You can run this program and you will see that this is the original data set sas.class, and this is the frequency when you look for the table statements sex. So you can see that there are 9 females and 10 males, and these are the percentage cumulative frequency, and these are the cumulative percent. So this is the frequency and this is the percentage. So this is how the results will come when you will run Proc Freq procedure. So you can control unwanted statistics if you want. For example, if you are not interested in percentage or cumulative frequency or cumulative percent, you just need like your variable's name and number of frequency. So you can use NOCUM. So NOCUM option will remove these cumulative frequency and cumulative percentage informations, whereas NOPERCENT option will remove the percentage informations from your table. So you can see when I will run this program, you have to write options after slash NOCUM and NOPERCENT. So when you will run this program, you will see a table with just name of the variables and the frequency. So this is how you can control the output. And so another option is N levels option. So N level options, basically you can write in the Proc Freq statement here, and it will give you one extra table in your output, and that will count you the number of unique values in the variables. So for example, this is the Proc Freq. I'm just writing both together, so you will know the difference. So one without N levels options and one with level options, with N levels options. So you can see that how the output was coming. So this is the Proc Freq without N levels option, and this is Proc Freq with N levels option. So here you can see one additional information is added. You can see there are levels five. So you can see frequencies of X is 4 and 1 missing. So total 5 levels are there. 1 is missing and non-missing is 4 different variables. So these information will come when you will use N levels options, here. So you can do with same with another data set, and you will see the outcome with two different tables will come. So this is how you can change the output, and you will look for the values. And this is the missing options that you have to provide in table statement. So I'm removing missing information here and will run both of them together, so you will see that what the missing option is going to do here. So you can see the output. So missing information, if you put the missing option in table statement, the missing will included in the table as well here. But here missing is coming at the bottom as a message here or as a footnote. But when you are using missing as an option here in table statements, it will be included in your table. So this is how the missing information can be handled in your data set. And you can also output your procfreq information in a separate table. For example, then you have to write out here a statement after the table statement, after giving a slash and the name of the output data set here you can provide. So when you run that, I'm using no print option, so there will be no print. If you will keep your print information, you have to remove no print. So this is the printed information of the procfreq procedure, and this is the new data set that is generated. So when you will use no print option here, you will not see the print, and only the output of a new data set will be generated, which contains only the procfreq informations that we are trying to get the information. So here we have count information and we have percentage information. So this is how you can handle the data set, and you can generate a new data sets from the procfreq procedure. Another important thing you can do in procfreq is the use of the format statement. So this is it's simple procfreq tables from SAS dot cars dataset, and you can see that we looked for the different MSRP and their frequency here, like how many. So most of them looks one actually, so that's why this table is so big, and that's why we plan to use here the format, proc format. So we gave a range of the value and gave the value for that in a format form. So for 10,000 to 19,999, we are including in this format. And likewise, so this is the proc format procedure I just ran, and I'm using the format information in procfreq statement, and this MRP is now giving the format of this. So when you will run this program, the table will change actually. So you can see that. So now the frequency from 10,000 to, one less than 20,000 is 98. So this is the how frequency distribution is changed and percentage is changed now. So this is one thing you can do that in procfreq. And another important thing you can do in procfreq is cross-tabulation. So basically you can create 2x2 or n-by-n multi-way tables. So for example, I have to create this X and Y table in a cross tabulation form. So this one I am going to run all together, so it will be easy to understand. So the first procfreq is based on variable X, the second one is based on variable Y, and this is the cross tabulation. So you can see that when you are using procfreq with table statement X only, so you have four records here, and giving all the information about frequency, percentage, and cumulative frequency and cumulative percentage. And this is procfreq using table statement Y, and this is the cross tabulations X versus Y. So you can see that X various are on the this side and Y variables are on this side. So the first line is the frequency, the second line is about the percentage, and third line is the row percentage, and fourth line is about the column percent, and this is all total actually is also coming, and missing value will come at the bottom actually, and it will tell you that how many variables are missing. So this is, you know, about the cross tabulation. So you can do three-way also, you know, frequency calculation, and that is also possible. Again, if you want to limit certain information, you can do that using no column or no row options here. So I will run this one and will show you how the output is going to change. So only frequency and percentage is now coming. So no row and no column is also working here. No information is displaying. And if sometime we need our, you know, output to display in a much better way, display in a more, you know, readable format. So to improve it, you can use list option here. So this is a normal, I will tell you that how the output is going to change when you will use list option in your table statement. So let's run this program and I will show you. So this is how the normal output when you will use Proc Freq, and this is with the list options, you know, when you will use list options in your table statement. So the, you know, the format is changed and it's more readable. Like you, if X value 2 and Y 2, how many frequency are there? Here you have to, you know, look, you know, one by one, and you have to, it's not easily readable, but this one is easily readable. And if you have a large data set, it's very convenient to check, you know, how many combinations of the variables and what are the frequency of that combination. So that is very much doable. And you can see again, I'm using the same program for a different data set, sashelp.cars. And you can see this is the output. It's not very much readable and easily, you know, understandable. But here, the second one where I'm using list options, you can see that how convenient and how readable this data set is. So this is the use of the list, you know, option, so that you can do that. And if you need some time to generate multiple tables, so for example here you have to generate two different tables. One is X versus Y, and Y versus X and Y versus Z. So you have to put a bracket and then you have to put the, you know, asterisk mark here. So when you will run that, so two tables will be generated. One is YX and YZ. Likewise, so when you will run this program, so two separate tables will be generated. So you can see that this is YX and this is YZ. So same way, like if you have a four, you want to generate, you have four variables, A, B, C, D, you want to different combination, you can do like this. So A, C, and AD and BC and BD. So four different table will be generated from this table statement. So this is how you can change your output here. So another is the wait statement. Wait statements when you already have counts actually. So for example, this is the normal, you know, output from the data set. I can show you here. So this is the normal where you can see the frequency is displaying, and but when you will use wait statement, it will include the real value of the count. So this one, you can see that how the values are going to change here. So you can see frequency is not displaying here. Instead of that, the values are displaying. So the counts are displaying. So I'm going to run both of this, you know, statement together, so it will be easy to understand. So here you can see the frequency, you know, is one time, but here is the values, is count is coming. So this is the use of the wait statement. And another important, you know, analysis you can do in Proc Freq is chi-square analysis. Chi-square analysis is a statistical hypothesis test used to analyze the, you know, in contingency table. And the main purpose of chi-square is to look whether, you know, two categorical variables are independent in influencing the test statistics or not. That you can do that, and to determine the significance between the expected and observed frequency in more than one category. So suppose if you wanted to look, you know, the chi-square test between these two variables, MEC and MSRP, in this SAS help.cars dataset. So when you will run this program, you will see, you know, an outcome will come here, and you can see the frequency chi-square testing, and you could see the p-value is like, you know, less than 0.05, so that it's not statistically significant. So that kind of analysis you can do that, you know, using Proc Freq. And another thing you can do in Proc Freq, you can plot, you know, your results as well. So for example, here in the table statement, you have to write slash plots and Proc Freq plots, and type is bar here, bar diagram we are going, and we are using percentage here. So when you run this program, so you have to on sometime, you know, graphics, ODS graphic on and off that you can add, and you can see this is the frequency and this is the percentage. We are using percentage here, and you can see that how the bar diagram is generated. This is the percentage and this is the Y variable. So this is easily doable in a Proc Freq statement, and this is when you need a dot plot actually instead of, you know, bar diagram. So you can write dot here, and I'm not using a scale here as a percentage. So you can see that how the value is going to change here. So you can see, so this is not the percentage, but here it's actually the frequency is, you know, displaying. So this is how you can generate different kind of plots using Proc Freq. So this is all about the Proc Freq, which is one of the most you know, useful procedure in SAS programming, and I hope you like this video. Thank you very much.